People, welcome back to Politics Watch. So today we're going to talk about the incident that happened in Arfitree when two plainclothes policemen challenged a couple of 87 Octanes who had came to do a contract hit on a man who we're now being told apparently was some kind of taxi man, but we're not sure. Now, I don't want people to think that I'm attacking the policemen who responded to the incident, okay? I understand that in the heat of the moment, it's much harder to make these decisions, right? And as a policeman, it's very difficult to see something like that happening and not do something, right? However, the decision the two plainclothes officers made to challenge the man in the middle of Arfitree was total disaster. It was a mistake. They made the wrong decision. I mean, I hope they don't get like in any serious trouble, because again, I mean, their intentions were good, but as they say, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. Now, the reason why this is a bad decision is because you cannot challenge a couple 87 Octanes to a shootout in the middle of Arfitree. Arfitree is like Jamaica's Times Square or Piccadilly Circus or downtown Toronto. You simply do not do it. The risk is too great. The odds of something, of a civilian getting hurt, are too high, right? What they should have done, in my opinion, is to keep visuals on the men, because they already saw them carry out the first hit, right? What they should have done is to keep their eye on the men, chase them, but not directly chase them. Don't run behind them and make a bag of noise. Oh, stop, police! Don't do that. Don't alert them that you're plainclothes police officers, because by this point, everybody are run up and down because of the initial sound of gunshots. So the 87 Octane criminals don't know who is plainclothes police and who is civilian. They just see a bag of people run up and down. What the officer should have done is kept an eye on them, followed them until they were out of the crowd, until they are away from the main congested area in Arfitree, because they might eventually take some kind of lane or some kind of back alley, or try jumping at some vehicle or something like that to get away. That is where the officer should have engaged them, if it is safe to do so there also. And if everywhere they look, there was crowded people, there were a crowd of people, then they should have let the men escape. Now I know that line is going to trigger a few people's emotions. What do you mean, make them escape? They had to do something. Listen, in this kind of work, you always ask yourself, what is the worst case scenario for either option? The worst case scenario of letting them, of not challenging the men, is the first man would have died, and then they would have gotten away, okay? But 100 people see them face, including police officers, who can then identify them. There are cameras all over Arfitree. Those men would not have been on the run for very long. Okay, there are cameras all over Arfitree, 100 witnesses, including the plainclothes officers, who could easily have come back and said, yep, these are the men, I saw them myself. That is the worst case scenario of the men getting away. The other scenario, what was the worst case scenario for that? Well, it happened. Innocent civilians ending up getting hit. 4 people at that. Right? We don't know the conditions on all 4 of those people. As a matter of fact, we're actually lucky it's only 4 people. This is Arfitree we are talking about, you know, people. At any time of the day, Arfitree busy, you know. You cannot challenge criminals to a shootout in a crowded area. Now, I know in the movies, you see policemen chase criminals and pie, pie, pie. Everybody are shooting and only the criminal get hit. In real life, that's not how it works, people. in real life, the men you're chasing, the 87 octane criminals, definitely can't shoot accurately. And the policemen who are chasing them are at best average shooters. If the two of them start trade rounds in the middle of Alphatree, innocent people will lose their lives. This is real life. This is not a movie. And let me tell you something, people. I know it's difficult. I've been in scenarios before where I've been with the squad and we've been in positions where we wanted to. There was a possibility, there was an option to engage an enemy. But there were so many civilians around, we had to leave it alone. It's very difficult. Very difficult. But taking out one criminal is not worth injury or loss of life to one civilian. There is only one scenario, and I'm going to tell you this right now. There's only one scenario where a policeman or any lawman should engage a criminal in a setting like Alphatree or Times Square or any other crowded setting. I'm going to tell you what that one scenario is. That's if you're now faced with a scenario where the shooter is targeting random civilians. Like all these incidents where you hear happening all over America, people going on these rampages. If somebody's in Alphatree carrying out a rampage, then you must engage him. Because why? Either scenario equals the loss of life of innocent people. If you let him be, he's going to carry on taking out innocent people. And if you challenge him, then innocent people will be hurt, yes, but then at least you would stop the threat. And you would lower the loss of life. But in this scenario, where some 87 octanes carry out a mission and are now escaping, to then challenge them to a shootout in the middle of Alphatree was the wrong decision. And this is why Indicom has gotten involved. So Indicom is going to carry out an investigation to find out whose weapon fired the rounds that hit the civilians. Because now we don't even know if the people who got shot, if those rounds came from the 87 octanes. It could have been from the two plainclothes police officers. And let me tell you something as well, Jamaica. And Jamaicans all over the world. This could have been much worse, you know. You know how it could have been worse? When you look at the initial video, or the photos, right? It looked like the plainclothes police officers themselves look like criminals, you know. Right? So you know what could have happened? Uniformed policemen could have seen the two plainclothes policemen chasing or running down the road with weapons in their hand and then challenge them to a gunfight. And now we're in real problem because now we have plainclothes police, a fire shot off a 87 octane, and uniformed police, a fire shot off a plainclothes police. Because the first time I saw that video, the first time I saw the images, I thought the plainclothes policemen were the criminals. I thought they were the 87 octanes. So luckily, we didn't have a scenario where some other uniformed officer from a distance just looked down the road and see these two men running with machine at them on and decide to go challenge them. Things could have been much worse. Now, as I said, I don't want people to think I'm attacking these officers. I understand why they did it. I understand 100% why they did it. That would be their natural instinct. But people, police pursuits are overrated. Only in the movies do they usually go wrong. As a matter of fact, in some countries, I know in some countries like the UK and other European countries, police officers are trained to not pursue criminals unless there's absolutely no civilians around. This old drive through the streets and a fire through window and all these things you see in movies. A lot of countries have completely banned that from their police force because what's the goal? Okay, you catch the one criminal, but now 3-4 innocent people have lost their lives. Anyway, people, this is Politics Watch. Jump in the comment section and tell me your opinion on this. And again, I want to clarify, I'm not attacking those officers. I understand why they did it, but it was the wrong decision. Big up yourself.